Hello, and welcome to North Central College Chamber Orchestra's Fall 2020 concert. You know, it's almost taboo to say 2020 out loud these days. It really has been a tumultuous year full of struggles and hardships for everybody. But I can say with certainty that for everybody on this stage today, this orchestra has been a nice little white light of hope, honestly, in all of our lives. And, you know, it's something that we get to do every week in person where almost no other ensembles get to. So today we wanted to share some of that joy of music making with all of you at home. Now, obviously, since this is a virtual performance, we can't give you printed programs. But if you check the description of the video in the YouTube page, you'll be able to see everything that we're performing today. We just started with Leroy Anderson's Arietta, and now we'll be moving on to the Baroque period and Vivaldi's Concerto alla Rustica. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
The next piece on our program is Edward Elgar's Serenade for Strings, First Movement. Elgar wrote just an outstanding amount of incredible string orchestra music in his life, and by far, this piece is the most performed and most well-known. It has an incredible history of being performed by some of the greatest string orchestras in the world, and we would like to add to its history today, although it will not be me conducting the ensemble. This semester, we have been very fortunate to have an extremely gifted, talented, musical young student assistant conductor. Normally, he sits in our clarinet section, but today I wanted to give him his first chance to conduct an orchestra in concert. The orchestra loves him, I'm sure you will too. Would you please help me in welcoming to the stage Alessandro Ayala. Congratulations, Alessandro. Wonderful job. The next piece on our program will be Jean Sibelius' Andante Festivo. He originally wrote the piece in 1922, and actually as a string quartet. And it wasn't until 1938 that he reorchestrated it for chamber orchestra. He chose this piece because someone asked him to do one of his own pieces on a public radio broadcast. And at the time, the technology was not as good as it is now, and there were a lot of audio distortions that you could hear on the radio every few seconds. So he wanted to pick a piece that would translate well over radio. So he took this piece, reorchestrated it, and conducted it very slowly for the public radio. Obviously, in 2020, we have very different challenges. And you can see on stage, we're all socially distanced, we're all wearing masks, and there are fewer of us than normal. So one of the challenges for the strings is that at a certain point, you run out of bow, and you can't create any more sound. And the slower you go, the more difficult it is to keep that going. So we have actually had to do the opposite and make it faster than normal. And to me, that's just one of the fun parts about live performance and about being in an ensemble, is that no two recordings of one piece are going to ever be the same. But regardless of the tempo, it's a beautiful piece of music, and we hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
The last piece on our program will be a piece by Edvard Grieg, two of his Norwegian heirs. And just like the Sibelius, actually, this piece was not originally written for chamber orchestra. It was written for piano, and later on in life, Grieg took the piece and reorchestrated it for strings. Grieg and a whole bunch of other composers did this, but I feel that Grieg was one of the best at writing chamber orchestra music for string instruments. He just understood the sound that you could get from a string orchestra like nobody else, in my opinion. I want to take a moment to thank some very important people right now. First and foremost, I want to thank Dr. Jonathan Kirk, our music department chair, who has been invaluable in navigating the difficulties of this semester with all that's going on with COVID on campus. And I also want to thank all of the music faculty, the string faculty, all of the students on stage here today, and those at home, for making the effort and coming in every week despite the challenging circumstances. And I want to thank everybody for tuning in today and listening. We hope you have a happy Thanksgiving, a happy holidays, and most importantly, a happy new year.